Hi guys, it's Maaike. Today I'm back with the Monstre de Carpath. Carpathian Monsters. I hope I said that right because my French... Anyway, this is the card I made. And I used the leftover rubber from the rubber stamps when I cut the monsters to make circles. And here they are, the Katzenkraft Monstre de Carpath. Yeah. I lived in Italy, but French eludes me, I'm sorry. And I tried die cutting first, but you can of course use any shapes that you have. Those were the Samson's stem present and ornaments, and see. Svinitz didn't cut it. If you have the big rules, those steel ruler dies, they might cut for it. I used the precision plate as well, and I almost didn't manage to put it through. So instead I just traced the die with a pencil, and now I'm cutting it out off screen. I'm sorry. I'm trying to make it as round as possible by doing it in one cut, but then I had a bit of little stray. I didn't cut it really straight, but I think it doesn't really matter for this instance. If you want something that's really properly round, you're probably want to buy the set Lots of Dots, I think it's called, for Simon System. There's many around there that have dots and triangles, and that would have been an easier shape. You can use any shape for this, I mean, it doesn't matter. I'm just using the circles to color my monsters. And I thought about doing some masking and putting them all together, but I didn't want to overcrowd the card, so I only used 3. You can use 1, you can use 5, you can use the whole pack if you want. It's all up to you. And I don't mount my rubber stamps, I just use a bit of tape runner, preferably not on the card front. Yeah. And then I just place them, and you can't see if they're straight, but I use the grid on the board. And then realign them more or less. I'm using VersaFine Onyx Black ink because I want a nice black impression. And most of these are new, but they stamped pretty well the first time. I just didn't apply enough pressure, I think, just there. So I stamped it another one. Tame. It's okay now, there's a hair, but yeah, I didn't see it. So for the sentiment, I'm using the Samson Stamp You Matter stamp set, and it says make the world a better place. You're probably supposed to use a U in there as well, but it's just make the world a better place. You know, it doesn't have to say you, I think. And because there's monsters, they could be aliens, I thought that would go very well. Otherwise you can just use happy birthday if you want. That's also in there. And I just like make the world a better place because it says world. And it's like an order, make the world a better place. Yeah. I'm just rationalizing it in my head. And I wanted to show you this card. I got it today from Georgia, and she made this for me. I sent her those stamps, You Will Never Regret Being Kind, and the little froggy, and she made me a card. So thank you, Georgia, I love it. And back to the card, I have my circles. I'm just mounting them on an acrylic block. You can use the Misty, of course, because I'm moving the circle a lot. I didn't see a point of using a stamp positioner. I'm using mementos, just colors that I think would look nice. But then I thought teal seal might be a bit dark. And I wanted the circles to be a bit more in the background. So I went for summer sky instead. And I'm just putting them randomly on the card, making sure I hit a monster here and there. And yeah, the VersaFine lifted a little bit, so I'm heat setting it now just to be sure. See, the eyeball is there. And Lilac Posies was a bit too dark for me too, so I switched that to can't remember, let me see, Angel Pink. I want to say Spun Sugar, but that's a different brand. And that, yeah, if you have three sizes, that would be nice. And there's, I put the tape on the back. There's a bit of, yeah, little indentations on the back, and the other side is smoother. So if you want a really smooth circle or stamping, then make sure you use the right side. I don't think it doesn't really matter, because you get a bit of texture. And of course you can color these monsters with your markers, but I thought this was very nice and very quick. And you can put as many circles as you want. You can also put them in rainbow order if you want to. But I just went more or less randomly, and then I switched to the present and ornaments circle, and I grouped the colors together, but just a different tone, because I think the smaller the dots are or the circles, the darker they can be. So if you put those really big ones dark, they take all the attention away from the rest. And you can see they look good on my grid there. But that was a bit dark. Still, there's not a lighter one, so I had to go with it. And I'm sure you can use any brand that you have. I only have the Dewdrops for stamping and the Versa Magic, but those are not really transparent, so I didn't want to use those. And you can also use distress inks, but then they don't really stamp very, very well. A bit splotchy. And if you like that look, then go for it. See, I went blue with blue and purple with purple and then yellow with yellow. I didn't mean to, just kind of worked out that way. I'm not sure why. You see, blue, blue, green, green, purple, purple. Then I just thought, yeah, put yellow there as well. He's gonna put it. No. See, I didn't want them to look like the Olympic rings, so I had to make sure I put it somewhere it doesn't go into an order. And again, you can use rectangular, you can use triangular cut ones, anything that you have. I think it looks nice and it's kind of different. I hope you like it, and I hope that gives you another idea what to do with your rubber stamp scraps. And I will see you again very soon. Thank you for watching. Bye.